Good morning, music teachers. I am going to teach you how to install the fonts or whichever fonts you need. Okay, so all of the fonts are linked in here. So the first one is the Rhythms font. That's the one of the most important, and which I put right here next to Matt's website. So go ahead and press Control and then left click to go to the link. And Matt's website will open up. There's Matt. And then you're going to scroll down to where it says Rhythms. And then you have to choose either Mac or Windows. I'm going to click on Windows. And then you can see I've already downloaded this a few times. It has the number 3 right there. I've had to do a couple of takes. That's all right. I'm going to put this in my fonts folder. So this is an okay location for me. You could just change your location by clicking on another folder on the left, or scrolling through to find a new one. I'm going to press save. Once I press save, there was a recent update, and most of the time, if you haven't updated, your downloaded items are probably down in the left-hand corner of your screen, but the recent update to Windows has made all downloads come up here to the bar. Go ahead and click on the zip folder, and then click on the folder that it opens for you. And then this is the file, Rhythms right here. So you would click on this, and it's going to open this text up right here. You're going to click Install. Now, for me, it says that I have already installed it. Do you want to replace it? I'm going to go ahead and say yes. It's not going to hurt anything. And then it gets reinstalled. Then you can X out of this and your other windows. And just know that anytime you install a font, the next time that you want it to show up, you do need to exit the program that you're using and then reopen it so that it shows up in your font list. Okay, so for example, if I click on some text, it opens my font window and I can type in Rhythms, and Rhythms shows up there, and I am all set. So the only other font you really need to install is Geologica. Geologica is the one that makes the PowerPoint legible. Oops, looks like I made a mistake here. Hold on a second. Whatever I did there, Control Z fix most things. All right, anyways, just happened to notice it. All right, Geologica is just to help read the document. That's the only one that you actually need. Litov, I just threw it in here. It is a free commercial font. The Roman numerals, that's how I made them. I used the font Litov. It just looked a lot nicer. And then Parisian, I only downloaded that one to create the octave up, octave down. That's all. Okay. All right. Oh, and if you do happen to go to that website, this is what it looks like. Should look like this, BB font family. And then you just literally click down here where it says download. Under here, okay. On the right hand side, these are all different other fonts. Anytime that you're downloading a font and you want to make sure that it is for commercial use, on this site they put it the license right here, which is nice. You can see free for commercial use. Awesome. But a lot of times text files are created for a font. And you can find the licensing information inside the actual font folder. So I'm actually going to go back to my font folder to show you this. All right. So if I click on fonts and I pick a random font. Okay, that one doesn't have it in there. Actually, let's go to the one we just did. Rhythms. All right. So most of the time when you click on these, there are other things in here or other documents. And sometimes these documents have information in them, like the licensing information. Like, for example, this is how I figured out that Matt created this. He has his website here, so you could go to it to find this person and then ask whether or not they licensed it. But usually with the font, there's some kind of read file or something like that that would give you more information about the font. All right, that's it. That's it for me today for installing fonts. Have a great day, everybody.